Hey guys, thanks for checking this out. I want to share with you the 10 things that you should know before upgrading to Windows 7. If you're buying a computer brand new that comes with Windows 7, that's great, but there are a couple things you need to know with transferring your files over, or is your printer compatible before you can buy that. The first one is compatibility of the drivers in your computer. Now, if you're upgrading, you need to run the Windows 7 Upgrade Advisor tool. You can either Google that or go to this direct link and that you'll see on the screen here and download and run this tool, and it's going to do a check on your system and let you know if the drivers are good and will work with Windows 7 or they're not currently up to date, but you can download updates that will make it work. Or worst case scenario, it's not going to work at all and you need to update your hardware for that particular device in order for it to work with the Windows 7. The second thing is the program compatibility. Now, even though the device manager checks programs with device drivers and so on, there's some programs that you'll need to maybe look at, like IncrediMail, for example, doesn't work with Windows 7 apparently. You'll need to download some other tool, like for email, since there's no email program that comes with Windows anymore either, with Windows 7. But there is the Live Mail, which works, and that's fine. At least there's something available that you can download and use. So check out all your software programs that you use. Make sure that they are compatible with Windows 7. Number three, back up your data. You should always be backing up things anyway, so this is nothing new, but so many times I have people come to my shop with a computer and they want some work done and they ask me, can you back it up first? Well, they've never backed it up, but it prompts them to remember to start backing up when they go back home, but chances are it's probably still not doing it. So back up everything that you can find, everything you can think of before doing the upgrade, just in case. Especially if you're upgrading from Windows 7, because it can't be an upgrade, it's a fresh install. Backing up your settings. Now, we said back up your data. Backup settings for programs like your email. You can export them if it's Outlook Express, but it won't import them. So you'll have to go in there and write down what the settings are, make sure you have your password and that sort of thing so you can set it up again. Windows Easy Transfer. It's a program that comes with Windows 7 that helps you to easily transfer all your files and settings from Windows 7 or Vista to Windows 7. Now, it comes with Windows 7, but you'll have to download that program in XP or Vista, whatever you currently have, to do the backup of your settings, and then run it again when you're in Windows 7 to restore those settings. So, again, you can do a Google search for Windows Easy Transfer, and you'll find that that you can download and run. You can't upgrade from Windows XP. So if you're going from Vista, you can do a clean, or you can do an upgrade which will keep all the settings and data, so nothing will be lost. If it's XP, unfortunately, you have to back up everything and be prepared for a format and a fresh install. If you're thinking about doing a dual boot with XP or Vista, don't do it. Unless you're very technically inclined, you could be finding a lot of hassle with that, setting it up and dealing with other workaround issues that might come up. Windows 7 looks amazing, and a lot of people are saying it's amazing. So, and I use that for my main operating system, and I'm using that as I'm doing this video right now. So don't worry about the dual boot. I would say don't do it at all. If you're concerned about XP applications that won't work in Windows 7 and that's why you're considering doing the dual boot, don't worry about it. Windows 7 has features just like Vista where you can run in compatibility mode for XP. And also, if you're getting the Pro Edition or the Ultimate Edition, there is a feature where you can tell the program to run in XP mode, and that actually has XP virtual machine that runs in Windows 7. So it's like you're running XP within Windows 7 to run that program on. Rather than just in XP compatibility mode, it's actually running it within an XP virtual system that runs inside your Windows 7. Very cool. So you don't need to worry about that. Just make sure you don't get the Home Edition or you're not going to have that feature. Ensure all your disks are available before you get started. It's so easy to get started installing Windows, doing this and that, and then you realize, oh crap, there's another program I had that I need to install, and you gotta fumble around looking for that disk and then find out it's a download.
Then you have a number where you download the firmware if there's another capable one. Even for the videos that I'm doing here now, it doesn't have video capture available in the Windows Movie Maker like it had before, so I had to find another alternative for recording
videos. And that's something that you gotta think about ahead of time, otherwise you're gonna be scrambling again looking for another alternative, and you'll be stuck without making videos for a while. Know which version of Windows 7 you want. Windows 7, apparently now they've made it a lot easier with the versions. Not like Vista, it was just too many different versions to choose from. Windows 7, you can see here on the screen, will have the Home Edition and the Pro Edition and the Ultimate. And you can see with the Home Edition, you're pretty much getting everything you need. If you want to have some other special features, you can go to the Pro Edition, which gives you the option, if you're in a business, to join a network domain or to do the virtual XP machine, like I mentioned. And Ultimate just gives you a few extra little things, but unless you care about them, it really doesn't matter. Home Edition works perfectly fine. Pro Edition gives you a little more, and if you're in business, you're going to want to have Pro or Ultimate. Why upgrade at all? XP was great, but it's 10 years old now. Vista was crap. Some people use it and they find it's fine, but those people don't seem to use it as much. Windows 7, well, XP had its issues and got better with time. Vista was horrible right out of the gate and almost everyone was complaining about it. Windows 7, everyone's saying how great it is right out of the gate. So that has to say something about Windows 7. The support has already been discontinued for XP. It is over 10 years old now, but critical updates will be available until the year 2014. Windows 7 is much faster than XP and Vista. People have put Windows 7 on older machines and tested it, and it works great. So Windows 7 looks like Microsoft's really got it good this time. They've got a lot more features, both just cool features, which you can see in some of my other videos, and very useful features that you can do, whether it's personal or business. But have a look and check out my other videos, and you'll see some of the other features available in the Windows 7.